Hold on. I'm going to try to relaunch that one, though.
Our launch file is broken. There's something wrong in the code.
It did not launch.
It's not launched.
What's going on?
The United States Navy has developed a series of autonomy competitions for the next generation of surface ships.
So these are our main communication antennas.
We want to use our naval architecture skills to make a better autonomous platform. As leaders in the marine field, this is something we had to do. And thus, here we are in a storage locker with a boat.
Not gonna lie, a lot of this happened really fast. I've got this boat that I need to outfit with all these sensors, and a lot needs to happen to get a boat to drive itself. The first competition was in 2014.
We've had 5 months to work on this, and other teams have had 5 years.
I would love to win the competition. Surveillance of waterways is really difficult to do because the ocean is so vast. There's a lot of space to cover. There's a lot of information to garner. And so having that done autonomously has a huge advantage.
How should ships change with autonomy? From a ship perspective, autonomy is much more difficult because there's a lot more motions associated with the sensors.
So we've got camera at the top that's going to allow us to see 360 degrees around the vehicle. And then we have Velodyne LiDARs at both the forward end and the aft end. We're running out of time to get this thing done.
We're all not sure how this thing's going to work.
One, two, three.
And so getting it out there and seeing how it works and see how it performs, to get that data, that's the first thing we need to do.
A university alumni was kind enough to allow us to use his house.
Remember, don't set it on the concrete.
Which is right here on the lake, in order to test the vehicle.
So let us know when you're about to put it in the autonomous mode, okay?
Okay, it's running, yep.
Boat is autonomous, repeat, the boat is autonomous.
Roger.
And we're moving.
Watch out. Yep.
We went autonomous for the very first time ever today, so that was a huge achievement of ours. The boat knew its current position, it knew a final position that it wanted to go to, and we basically told it, hey, we need you to go 25 meters forward, which is the simplest thing you can possibly do. But that was a huge first step for us.
If we win, that says something right there. You know, with no budget, no time, in a storage locker, we beat, you know, 7 countries and a bunch of other U.S. universities. That would just be fantastic.